Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can implement these three patterns with the help of C program. Before starting, one information, if you go to detail or description of this video, you will find links of various playlists. Those are related to various programs, so you can watch them. Now, first I am going to explain the implementation of this pattern. So here you can see we have five different rows, and before printing alphabets we need to print spaces as well. So here I need to implement three loops. How I identify that? So first loop will be for identifying on which row we need to print alphabets, right? So let me write that here. So let's say this is first loop, and right now I am going to repeat it five times. Why so? Because five rows I have to print. So it will start. Now, before printing alphabet, we need to print some spaces. And if you see with the help of this dash, so dash is representing spaces here. So if you see the pattern of spaces, so in first row, four spaces, second row, three, then two, then one, and then zero. So these number of spaces we need to print, and after that we need to print the alphabets. So alphabets in first row 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, and then 5. So if we are on fourth row, then we need to print 4 alphabets. If we are on fifth row, then we need to print 5 alphabets. So this way alphabet loop will be repeated. So alphabet loop will depend upon the I, value of I, because I is representing row number. Now we need to identify how these spaces will be printed. So if you identify the logic, so we can write this. So if we write 5 minus 1, so 4, 5 minus 2, 3, and so on. So 5 is total number of rows, and 1, 2, 3, 4 is representing the current row number. So if we put this logic, then we will be able to identify how many spaces we need to print. So I am going to use this logic. So I am implementing second loop, which is J, and this J loop will repeat this time. So J is starting from 1, its condition is J less than equals to 5 minus I, and then J plus plus. And inside this loop, I have to print space. So this way space will be printed. So first I'm going to complete this program now, then I will be explaining each line so that you can understand how this will be printed. So be with me. So this is second loop, which is starting from 1, and it will also repeat. So here condition is k less than equals to I, and then k plus plus. Then opening the curly braces. And now you can see we need to print the alphabets. So alphabets are starting from A. So before starting the loop, I need a character variable. So here you can see I have declared a character variable, and this character variable is initialized with capital A. So it is the beginning value of this variable. And here inside this K loop, I'm going to print that character variable. So here you can see printf, then %c, and then ch. So ch variable will be printed with the help of ch, because we are going to print the characters. So if you want to print the characters, then we require %c. So this loop will print the alphabets. After this loop, completion of this loop, I am going to increase value of ch. So ch plus plus for that. And then I am writing printf and backslash n. And closing this, I fold. So this way I implemented the complete solution. Now I am going to explain it line by line so that you can understand how it will be printed. So initially value of I will be 1, starting from here, condition is true. Now come here to this loop. So now this loop will complete its rotation cycle. So it is starting from 1. Here see the condition, 5 minus I. So 5 minus 1, because value of I is 1. So 5 minus 1 is 4. So this loop will repeat 4 times, and it will print these 4 spaces. So So dash will not be printed, space will be printed, because inside this double quote here you need to put a space using space bar. Then after completion of this loop will repeat. It will repeat one time because here condition is k less than equals to I. So value of I is 1. That's why this loop will repeat one time and it will print the value of ch. So ch is right now 8, so it will print 8. After completion of this loop, so initially ch was a, after completion of this loop ch will be incremented to b, and then printf will be printing backslash n, so that control will be transferred to new line. Then I plus plus, so I will become 2. Again control will be transferred to this loop, so 5 minus 2, this time it will be 3. So this loop will repeat 3 times, so 3 spaces will be printed. That this loop will be completed, control will be transferred to this loop. Now value of I is 2, so this loop will begin from 1 and will go to 2, so it will repeat 2 times. It means ch will be printed 2 times. So see the value of ch, it is b. So b will be printed 2 times. And why 2 times b? Because inside this loop we are not changing the value of ch variable. So that's why it will print same value. So if k loop will repeat 2 times, so 2 times same value which is available in ch will be printed. Now after completion of this loop, ch will be incremented, so it will become c. Control will be transferred to new line, then I plus plus, so I will become 3. Now as per value of I, this loop will repeat 2 times and this loop will repeat 3 times. So it will print 3 times value of ch, that is c. So this way this pattern will print, this way this program will print the pattern. So here you saw 3 loops are available. First is controlling row, second is printing spaces, and third is printing alphabet. Now we can easily convert this into this, because space logic will be same, row logic will be same, we just need to manage the printing of alphabet. So here you can see at the beginning every time we need to print A, and then we need to increase the value of alphabet wherever we are printing that. So before starting this, I am initializing it with A and I am shifting the CH plus plus inside this loop, right? So I am going to iterate it let's say 2 times so that you can understand how it will work. So quickly, I equals to 1, condition is true, so CH will be initialized with A. This loop will repeat 4 times, so 4 spaces will be printed. So let's say 4 spaces are printed. Then this loop will repeat one time because initially value of I is 1 and it is A. So it will print A. This is printed. Then CH plus plus. So it will become B. Then this loop will be terminated. We will move to new line. Then I plus plus, I will be 2. Then here you see again CH will be initialized with A. Then this loop will repeat 3 times. So 3 spaces will be printed. Then we come here, it will repeat 2 times because value of I is 2. Then first time CH will be printed. So here you can see value of CH is A. So this A will print, then CH will become B. So printing of CH and increment of CH is one rotation that is done. Now again CH will print. So you can see value of CH is B now. So that is printed and it will increment to C. So two rotations are completed. Then move to new line. I plus plus, and again you can see CH is initialized with A. So every time we need to print A from the beginning of row, and then we need to increase the alphabets. So that's why initialization is done here and increment is done inside this A loop. Okay, so I hope you understood two minor changes and this pattern is implemented. Now simply we can implement this one. So one change, remove this from here. Don't initialize, because every time we are increasing only, and before starting I, we need to initialize CH with A, and then whenever the value of CH will be printed, just after it will be incremented by 1, and rest of the logic will be same. So see how easy this is, right? So this way, I hope you understood how we can print these patterns with the help of nested loops. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel and go to playlist. There you will find various programming related videos. So do watch them. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. So thank you for watching this video.